Did I save RA? Yeah, I did. Yeah, that'd be really cool. Oh, yeah, okay. Whoa! I can attack these people? Oh, I can attack them, Oh, I remember this. I used to level this way. Oh, yeah. Wow. I might do that, actually. I gotta talk about something, though. I don't think I really need this, too, but... Yeah, I remember I used to do this, like... I would do this for... I don't know, about like 3 minutes or something. Let's do that. I'm gonna start... No, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it for... I did it for 3 minutes. Dude, 3 minutes. Get my clock right now. So I'll just talk about something. I think I want to talk about... communicating. I'm big on communications. I am so glad I went into the field of information technology. Yeah, I worked, I put a lot of money, my own money, to buy the degree practically. A lot of what education's got is buying that degree and making sure you don't mess up either. You do not want to, I mean, if you're a high school student or even a middle school student, you cannot mess up in college at all. Yeah, it's not, you know, it's not, I'm not saying that you shouldn't pursue it, but you cannot mess up once you get into, especially in the university level, because that's, it's money. A lot about money. That's what all these students are finding out, that, you know, this is, college is not free. It's an expense. It talks about, you know, paying up for, to get a better job. But you do need it. I can say that, you do need, at least an associate degree. Get your associate degree. I know somebody, a place I work, I'd love to see his job title. I just don't want to give any information about him. But he has an associate degree, and a really nice one too. It's psychology, and I mean, I admire people who go out even to get their associate degree. I mean, a lot of time has been put into getting that, it's very admirable, and it's worth the ink it's written on. I mean, because it proves that you will complete something, and the general education, not just general education and the associate degrees. There's, because I have one in second studies, and, I think it's, in addition to the GE, which you are required to have anyway, even for a bachelor's degree, there's no degree that you can get that does not have, GE requirements, but, and we're not talking about, you know, like, mommy, doc, daddy, you know, hold my hand, to get the GE stuff. It's not like your high school stuff, either. What am I doing? It's, I mean, you have to work at it. You have to put the time down. What's he doing? Face this way. But why was I saying that? I just believe that everyone should have education, but why was I saying that, mention associate degree? Oh, I say it because I'm so glad I got my career in information technology. I mean, communication is a big thing about, my life. It's, about the things I'm really interested in. It's not just, like, speaking communication, but the way we can communicate. It's because... communication is not being about a good communicator. there are people out there who cannot communicate at all. And, you know, like, move a digit around, like a finger. Or, you know, say some, make some sounds or something. But being able to hear, you know, be able to transmit that voice, the speech to someone, is, you know, a big deal. It's not about being perfect about communication either. It's, you know, you just do it however you want. I mean, a lot of people have barriers to communications. There are a lot of people who have disabilities who have barriers or not. Nobody has given them a chance to talk about their disability, for example. You know, they can't express why they don't feel like disability should prevent them from, you know, doing something like what I'm doing. But a lot, you know, this is something that that one guy who's in Ilya or Julia, yeah, he has a disability. I think we all know that. And it's something he's able to do, and through this type of art, I guess I'd call it, he's able to communicate about everything about his life, about the barriers, things that he doesn't understand, the things that we had not really thought to look at it from his, you know, to understand it from the way he sees it. Like, what are examples of that? Well, he doesn't understand that, and a lot of people, including myself, do not understand that eating healthy doesn't mean, you know, taking the grease off of pizza. It's still not healthy. And everyone, I mean, if I were to say that I use napkins on my pizza to take the grease off, and I'm not saying anything against him, by the way, but I'm just saying that because we know his way of thinking, then it gives us good perspective of, you know, diet and health issues, like what people will go to try to be healthy. So if I looked at something like that and said, there's this guy who uses napkins to make his food more enjoyable, and while preventing, you know, degrading his health. So, what is the problem here? The problem is that food is not enjoyable. Healthy food is not enjoyable for this guy. So, how do we make it more enjoyable? How do we make it more like pizza without the grease and without the other stuff that's added? So, I mean, yeah, that's happening right now. I mean, there's, you know, cookbooks on how to eat healthy. Yeah, I think that's great. And just learn a little bit more through communications, through getting that feedback from, that was weird. What was all those chimes? No, those aren't chimes, it's, like, symbols. No, it's not symbols, it's chimes. Symbols aren't chimes, right? I don't know. So communications, there's communications about, you know, what about the people who perished in that building that didn't have a fire escape? How would we have known? Well, we know because somehow that information got out. It, political science teachers got word of it. And now it's going to the students. And the students are now mentioning it to, you know, people like you. Just like what I'm doing right now, I mentioned it. So it's all, that's communications. It's a path that we feed information from one place to another place. So IT is great for that. I think IT is wonderful for that. Because now it's not just the students hearing it, but everyone is hearing about it through the internet. has everyone ever heard about that story before I mentioned it today? It's not a story, it's that. But I'm saying, you know, I'm kind of saying it in a story. I won't go into the semantics or stuff, but basically, have you ever heard about that? About the... I think it's like a... I think they're sewing or something. I'm not sure. It was I heard it like 6 years ago. But you can look it up, because that's even the better thing about the internet is, if you don't believe me, or if you want to hear more about the details, which I'm sure more of you are thinking, I want to hear more about the details, get on Google, if you're against kind of like a corporate internet stuff, what's another one, Yellow Fox or something, I forget what it's called. There's another search internet, you can use any search engine, and you'll find that story. All thanks to technology, and you know, it's a great thing to be a part of. It's a great thing that I feel privileged to be able to be part of building. Because I actually, at one time, I assisted a school in, you know, back when I was in school. I experienced Death Day 97, basically, and I went through all that. I was in the school putting up the wires on the day 97, and from there on. So, and that's, you know, that's where you definitely see, just level, just the level of where, getting a dry mouth again. Yeah, can you do that? So yeah, the extent of what schools are capable of for students. Basically it was 97 brought up all the wires connected us to, it was through a dial-up service. I actually got a whole bunch of papers on that. I found how it all worked through PPP, point-to-point protocol. Through dial-up service, and that's how the schools were, at least the school I went to California, Southern California, how it was able to connect through and feed information to all students. Great, I mean, I created a webpage, my first webpage on the internet, was sometime around 98, 99. I think it was like maybe a couple weeks after I did all that, actually after the lab was connected. Yeah, I created a page on the GeoCities, hyperlinks, added all the hyperlinks when I was there, headers, I added pictures and stuff. So I think, you know, technology is a big part of my life. It's it's great. I mean, I think it's the best thing. I sincerely love it. I've done a lot of stuff, from programming, web pages, networking. Oops, somebody's going to die. YouTube. I mean, even this is, you could say this is part of technology. I don't know, it's not really. Well, yeah, it's part of IT. I was able to take the technology and present information. more in the media area. But yeah, so what can technology do for us? We can talk about things we, Occupy Wall Street was able to get a fitting, foothold through the internet to spread the information, spread the data that would be doing things. It's not always for the best. I mean, there's, what are some of the negative things about the internet? If you think of some of the things I'm about to mention as negative, look at it this way. At least we know these things are going around, right? So, yeah, child abuse. We have, just all these horrific things. Selling, weapons in a neighborhood to destroy a neighborhood, basically, yeah. Through the internet. So it's part of history. It's part of things that we can read and understand that these are big issues. Could you say the same if there wasn't an internet? If you're talking, through, Dropboxes instead? But, Dropbox is like, putting a Dropbox is like putting a note, like a certain location, like a rock. Like, geocaching is sort of like Dropboxes, where you can drop notes into, to these geocaches, but Dropboxes are, the difference is that they're not documented. I think that's one of the biggest differences. They're not documented, and they try to keep you safe. Put them down. So, not every Dropbox is evil. Some of them are good. I'm sure the Army uses Dropboxes. I wouldn't be surprised at all to hold intel. If you can't, get on the radio and expect, it's like Cypher. Like, what was that German Cypher? Enigma, I think it was called. I don't know if I'm saying that right, Enigma, or something else. Where, there's the Germans, I think it was the Germans. Germans or Russians, it was one of those two. It's one of those two. It's scared that it all happened. Where US was able to capture the encryption codes. So you can't rely on encrypted encryption. So you certainly cannot always rely on the technology either. Hostile environments. So the next best thing is our Dropboxes. Place your note, encrypted note, into a Dropbox. Next person will be able to read it. Got 6 more minutes. Thank you. I think that's good enough. Let's save here. XP, save game. Oh, yeah, I do. Off to the next place. I think we know where that is. I think this is a castle I actually remember, not the other castle. I think I'm gonna do... No, I'm gonna do the castle, and then I'll take a break and I can offload all these videos over. Perfect. You know what this means? It means something bad happened. Oh boy. Person right over there. Can't imagine what that's all about. Alright, what you gotta say? I'm gonna do a little hissy fits. Oh yeah, hissy fit. Hissy hissy. So hissy. You're lying. Haha, don't you wish? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, really? She's gonna take him? Her? Cool. Alright, so I think we're all geared up. Let's just start. Actually, let me do this. Oh, there's nothing here? Oh yeah, there's stuff going on here. No, really, there is nothing here. Oh yeah, there's stuff here. Look at that. They're hiding. Oh, just wait. Just wait. Loomis, okay. Let's set some rules. How do we want to do this? That, I don't know, I think I like that. I want them to attack as much as possible because I know they're not going to have any issues doing that. And check out LinkedIn. Freelance writer. It's pretty good. It's funny. I love it. That's, so luminous. Something on our weapons. Dead. must be audit leveling.